Okay, in this video, I'm going to cover how we can export civil geometry, some alignment profiles. It's changed quite a bit from SS10, so we need a new ORD way of doing it. So what you have here is I've got a ramp 2 alignment. It also has an active profile, ramp 2 PR, and I'm going to use that. I'm going to take that out of this file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my OpenRoads modeling workflow, go to the geometry tab, and there's an import export button, a pull down. We're going to do the export geometry option. So I'm going to select it. And then it wants to know some of the settings in here. Well, when you first open it up, it defaults to 1.2. We want to change that version to 2.0, the latest version. We want only the active profile, unless you want to bring in other profiles with that alignment. You do have that option. Most of the time, we just really want to use that, use the active one, but that's the option here. And then the export type is going to be our land XML. That's what we want to export it as. So once that's filled out like this dialog has it, 2.0, only active profile, export type, land XML, we'll come out and we'll accept these inputs that we just filled out, land XML. And then we have to locate the alignment. So I'm going to zoom into this route, ramp 2, select it, and then go off in the blank area and reset to complete, which is my right mouse button. It wants to know what version of land XML we're going to use, and it's the 2.0. So if you didn't change it at that point in time, you can change it now. 2.0 and land XML, only active profile. In this case, yes, that's all I want to bring across. It's going to give us a wizard. How do we want to store this in ProjectWise? Now, you may have already checked this off and not get this option, but I leave it on for teaching purposes. So no wizard on this case, and OK. It's going to go to our data folder and make sure you're in the right data folder. And it's going to call it ramp 2 is what I want to call it, ramp 2 XML. Once I've got that in here, and I'll give a description of ramp 2 as well. I'll go ahead and hit the save button. And it's copying out the ProjectWise and it wants to check it in since we're not using it. And I checked it in. So if I go to ProjectWise and I look at it, I can see now there is a ramp 2 XML. So let's create a 2D file and bring that in, show you how that works. So if I go file new, again, no wizard. Okay, I'm gonna make sure I have the 2DC file for civil geometry, and I'm just gonna call it, let's call it civil underscore geometry underscore, let's call it ramp 2. We'll just call it that. Civil geometry, ramp 2, and I'll hit OK. So it's going to create a brand new file with all the base settings. No save as's and no legacy data hung over. You got a brand new clean file. Once we do this and open the new file, you'll see that there's a red X down on the bottom right. Now that's our GCS, and we would like to apply that. So to do that, we go to our utilities pull down, our ribbon, whatever you want to call it. Coordinate system, we'll do a from file, and then we're going to grab the terrain or the existing terrain. That's what we want for this job. Usually the surveyors have put that in there for us, so that's the one you want to grab. And so I see it's got the coordinates, I'm good to go. I can close this out, get the little green check mark, all is good. So now that we have that XML out there, let's import it into our file. So we go to geometry, import export option. Let's go to the import option. Okay, make sure you navigate to the correct folder. You should see your XML file that you created. In our case, it's ramp 2. I find it good, so I'm gonna hit the open button. When the open comes up, now it's important that you use the little plus signs. In our case, it's not really that important because we toggled on to bring across only the existing or the active profile. If you bring in more than one profile, then you're going to want to open these plus signs up all the way down to profile. You can see that there's some information in here. We see that we have a MoDOT baseline proposed. So it knows there's actually feature definition to that alignment that we exported. So that's good. And then we go down to our profile, and you can see there's only one to choose from. But if you had brought in more, this is where you'd want to pick the one that you want is active. So we're going to say ramp 2 and bring that across. And I always pick the profile It selects everything else for us. Since it does have a feature definition on here, we don't have to worry about assigning a feature definition down here at the bottom. Well, we do want to make sure our create civil rules is checked on. So once you've got that filled out the way it is, we'll hit the import, let it process, do a fit view, and we've got our alignment. Now, if I select it, you'll see that now we have civil rules. If we didn't have that checked on, we'd have to apply civil rules to this alignment, but we had it checked on, so it's all good. So next thing we want to do is go ahead and give it a annotation. So if we go for our drawing production ribbon, go to element annotation and use the annotate element. It could have been the large icon up top, whatever you want to do there. Annotate element. All I have to do is go out and left click, since I had it selected, left click to data point. And it will go out and it will create our annotation. If I click off in a blank area, you can see you've got your stationing on there, got your tick marks, got your curve data. All's good. Now if it's too large, we can change that to a 50 scale. And put that annotation that we have now, it shrinks it down to the size you want to see. And that's all there really is to exporting and importing geometry from an XML.